Welcome. It's another episode of How We Made It here at Let It Fly Media. I'm Tom Martin. This is our co-founder, Andrew Carter. And this is the one we've been wanting to do since we started this series. This is the Chiefs Parade in Kansas City. It was for the client, the KC Sports Commission. And we're just excited to show you guys how this thing went from even the inception of getting the gig into how we actually shot it on parade day and turned it around in about 5 hours and got it to the client. Here's the video now. This is a lot more than most of our videos have been, at least at the time, because it wasn't just this video. It was also a mini documentary for the KC Sports Commission.
Right.
And then in general, I mean, this took the entire team. And that was on parade day. Take me before that, you know, because we're trying to get any gigs we can. This is a crown jewel for us looking back, but how did we get it?
Well, I think we got it because we thought we'd be good for it. And a lot of times in this company, we, you know, we're growing. We're trying to go after anything and everything. And people will say, hey, why don't we try this? Or why don't we try to get this job? Is anyone else doing this? Kansas City Sports Commission was the people to get in contact with. Obviously, the Chiefs have their own team. They do an amazing job. But this was a city thing. This was a Kansas City thing. This was a generational thing, and we wanted to capture that.
And we hadn't seen other cities, at least to our knowledge, put out something that we felt we could put out.
Right. Like, I think in general, you always say, I want footage of that. But you think of maybe having a camera stable somewhere in one location, and then you look at it 30 years down the road. But why can't you have something more, something better that shows the entire experience?
Right.
And we thought we could deliver that to the Kansas City Sports Commission, and ultimately this city for years to come. That's going to be there, something to look back on decades down the line, which is really cool.
So we got together while Billy was at the Super Bowl. So Billy will come on in a bit, and he'll talk more about parade day.
Yeah.
But we're planning out how to do this at the KC Sports Commission. We have a big whiteboard. Just going through the planning process, how did we go from, okay, we have the gig, to how do we do it?
Right. So we got in touch with Kathy Nelson. She vetted us. We went through a process, and she's like, let's do it, guys. Like, I want you on this. This makes sense. We need this. And what they told us is in the past, they've done amazing events, but they don't have anything to show to get that next one. Mm-hmm. So we're in line for the World Cup. We're in line for some big things. This was a way that if Let It Fly could showcase what we do here, we can apply that and help this city get more stuff, right?
Right.
So we're finally there, and now we're in it. And it's like, okay, you got to plan before they win or lose. Like, we were in planning sessions before the game even started.
Right.
And now you're jinxing things. You're getting buses, ships to Kansas City. We're trying to figure out logistically where our broadcast camera is going to be. We don't want to get in the way of people. We don't want to get in the way of fans. How do we go up and down this parade route and visually capture what's going on for the best product? And that was a lot of moving parts.
I'm calling buildings, trying to get on rooftops.
Yeah, your job was crazy.
We designated who would shoot what, and I wound up shooting on rooftops. So yeah. I went that day, and we'll get more on that later, but I went that day from City Hall to Two Light to Rock Hill Grill, right, and just tried to make sure we got, as the parade went down, different aerial shots, but there's so much more involved. So,
well, that's kind of what I want to touch on. So yeah. Like, you're on buildings, right? And so when we're planning, it's like we have a team of 9 people. What are we going to do with those people? Because this is a mile parade route,
right,
and there's a lot to cover. There's players, there's fans, there's locations. So you've got Union Station, you've got Grand Boulevard where it starts. How are we going to do this? So we don't have to go into the details, but we had people at Union Station, we had people along the parade route, we had people we knew could get on the bus with the players, double pass Billy, and we had people like you, let's get on rooftops because we wanted different vantage points, different angles. You know, everything about this had to be all-encompassing. Because of the pre-planning, there was other things like the parade route. No one knew the parade route except for us and the Sports Commission for a while, so we created a video about
That's
showing
right.
people what the parade route was going to be, because it had to get out there, right? So the
right.
mayor announces this is the parade route, and then they released a video we created for them that showed fans what the route was going to be. That alone was like a crazy night, having to work all the hours to get that prepared.
Yeah, this is one of those where, like, we, based not just on our passion for sports, but also just loving deadline, we're yeah. journalism addicts in that sense that we are addicted to deadline. And so we loved being able to come back and, yeah, you'd love to sit on the couch at night after a long workday, or you put in extra hours to get this thing done because it was a moment. I think anytime you have a big moment in history in a city driving you to get something done, you work extra hard, you put in the extra hours, and we did that. So we get to parade day, and it was funny because we had a lot of different things we're being told. We were told there was going to be a flyover. We had a guy in Liberty Memorial. The flyover did not happen. We had all kinds of things we were getting ready for down the route. When you think back to this video and maybe shots that you're seeing as we have it pulled up here, what are you most proud of as far as how we got it done?
I think I'm so proud about how much we covered with the resources we had and how fast we were able to turn this around. To have all that footage, to go back and edit, and have Andy, our editor, who unfortunately we don't have time for everything, but he turned an amazing video around, and there was 9 different cameras of footage they had to go through, and we had it out by 7 or 8 p.m. that night, was probably the most incredible accomplishment we've had to this date, and it'll be hard to beat that.
Yeah, that was one where, besides music being picked out, it was, hey, everyone give me your best shots, and credit to Andy for putting it all together in a matter of hours in a way that is still memorable. We couldn't just say we got it done quick and half-ass it. We had to actually make sure it was memorable.
Well, and the last thing I'll say is, when people watch the video, I want them to know this isn't one person running around to this video just happens. This
right.
isn't like, just because of certain camera angles and shots we got, this video happens. This was hours of planning. Everyone in their position just completely crushing it and doing their job to their best ability, and it was a total team effort. And for that, I think we have one of the coolest videos that we've made and the city will have for years to come.
Yeah, I feel that. Andrew, thanks for coming on.
Thanks, man.
Billy Quach.
What's up?
Nice to have you here. So as our creative director, the first thing you were in charge of from afar, because you're coming back from the Super Bowl, this is a crazy week for you, was equipment, first off. I want people to know what we use to make this happen.
Yeah, this was an insane shoot equipment-wise. We had all our Black Magics in use. I believe we had 6 by that point. We had both our Sony A7S2s in use. We had Dakota bring his FS7. We had 2 GoPros, 1 360 camera, and a drone. It was basically our whole arsenal inventory of equipment. If someone had a free hand, they had a camera in that hand. But yeah, it was crazy.
And we had to find a way to keep warm because it was so cold out. We had to have hand warmers and all this stuff. So a lot
and
to
potential
manage.
Rain. So we had to have rain gear.
No
on all
kidding.
Our cameras.
We had it all with us, and we're all being mobile as well. Thank God they got us golf carts to go up and down the route.
Yep.
But you know, just watching this video, I think one of the things that stands out to me is not just the big wide parade shots, not just the big crowd shots, but some of the shots you got where they're much more personal and the players are giving you these great reactions. Kind of take me inside how you'd pull off something like that.
Yeah, so I was assigned to be on a truck as part of the parade route. Like, Andrew and I were supposed to be on a team. And we actually got a call from Tyree to join him on his bus. So I was like, okay, I mean, I'm not going to get this opportunity again, so let's do it. Got on his bus with the wide receivers, and that's how I was able to get all these close-up shots of all the players and basically just experience their perspective with them with a camera. That was huge in our telling of the story of that day.
Yeah, I think my favorite one is when he's getting off the bus, Tyreek is, and you get him with the trophy.
Yeah.
And, like, it legit to me felt like it was the first time he'd touched it. It wasn't, but you got that sense of excitement. How did you get that one?
Yeah, so that was actually pretty funny. Our bus got a little lagged a little bit behind. The bus in front of us was about, like, 200 yards away or so. And I noticed that the bus in front of us had the Lombardi on top. And I was like, oh, they must be passing Lombardi down bus by bus. So I'm like, oh, I hope they didn't miss our bus. Or, like, maybe I hope they're going this way and not down the route.
Right.
So I grabbed Tyreek and was like, yo, the Lombardi is on the other bus. We got to go get it. And he's like, all right, bet. So we both ran like 200 yards, just him and I running side by side down the route to get to the next bus.
Yep.
And it was like the most insane, surreal moment ever, because there's just fans screaming, roaring around us.
Yeah.
And it's just us two, empty street, basically running straight. And we get there, he goes in and gets the Lombardi, and I know I have to be ready for him to come out with it. And luckily, he comes out, perfect timing, right when I turn my camera to the door.
He's hyped.
And he's just, you know, giving it all.
Yeah, I that's got to be your favorite one. I got lucky, actually. I was on two light, and my favorite part of this was being able to involve some of the slowing down. I loved that we got the hype portions of this, but also being able to, you know, express. It's an emotional day for a lot of Chiefs fans who had never got to experience this. And I got one on two light of a dad and two kids of his who were breaking the rules. They were not supposed to be there. And before I told them, hey, just in case you guys know, I went ahead and hit record and got lucky on that. So, you know, it was, I think, combining all kinds of different things to make it work. One curious thing, you know, as far as how we shot this, it could have all been in a frame rate that was making it look like it was live. But a lot of this was actually slowed down.
Yeah.
And for people who don't know, you know, what goes into deciding whether you're going to shoot slower or more fast motion?
Yeah, so that is a very big decision in before any shoot, whether to shoot slow motion or in 24 in real time. Basically, we knew that this moment would be an iconic moment, and I really wanted to capture, you know, the excitement and the reaction in people's faces, and it's easier to notice those things when your stuff is slowed down. So most of us shot in slow motion in order to just grab that kind of grand, majestic vibe of the day. And then worst case, if we needed something to be in real time, we could just speed it up. So it's sometimes better to shoot in slow motion so you have options, whether instead of just choosing to shoot in real time and just being stuck with that.
What's the difference in your mind in shooting an event like this to show off the event or shooting to tell a story?
We're
obviously going for the latter.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, obviously we're trying to tell the story and not just, you know, frame up the entire place and hit record. And it's kind of a balance, because you got to show off what happens, but you also have to show off how it happened. And you got to tell, you know, the stories of the fans, the players, the coaches, the trophy, the route. Like, there's all these different subjects that you want to capture, and it's just all about finding a way to put it all together at the end.
Yeah, we just decided, I think, sound-wise, to limit it to just the speeches. We didn't want to have... We thought about having some fans maybe pipe in for a second and say something, but we felt like the fans' faces told more of the story for them, and Travis Kelce delivered. Thank God. That was amazing. And then I love how Andy ended it with the 1, 2, 3 with the different shots coming in and Coach Reed fittingly closing it off.
Yeah.
So any closing thoughts on just what you'll take from making this video?
I'm glad we had rain gear on, because even though it didn't really rain,
yeah,
there was a lot of champagne and beer and other liquids in the air.
We accidentally got that right.
Which I did not plan for.
Yeah.
So thank goodness that we thought it was going to rain, because if not, my camera would have been screwed because I was drenched from that parade.
But you couldn't have hated that. That was pretty fun.
Yeah, it was dope.
Okay. All right. Hey, we'll take more parade shoots if anyone wants to have us on them. Billy, thanks for your time.
Yep.